Hi, I'm Jeff Doniker. I live here in the Bay Area, California Bay Area, and I have redgreen colorblindness.
Okay, so redgreen colorblindness, we just sort of heard about that for the first time in the course, and we're learning a bit more about the inheritance patterns. What is redgreen colorblindness? What does it mean to be redgreen colorblind?
Well, to me, what it means is that I often mix up colors that have red in them. And so in particular, I mix up reds and browns, and sometimes browns and greens, because I'm not seeing the red correctly in those. Sometimes it can even show up in the form of blues and purples. I'm sort of seeing them all as about the same, and in fact, they may look different to other people.
When did you first know that you had red-green colorblindness?
I don't really remember. It was when I was a really young child. My uncle had been red-green colorblind, and then actually my mom's uncle as well. So I think I inherited it from her side. And so when I was a little kid, she recognized that I might be colorblind, or I had this propensity. And so she had me tested at one of the eye doctors, with looking at those little bubble charts with colors that you may remember having taken at some point.
So you were very young when your mother found this out.
That's right.
And did it cause any issue? I mean, it was like, okay, we knew this was a possibility, and now what kind of, if anything, was there to do at that point?
Not really much. As I say, her brother and uncle had it, and so she was sort of aware of it, and it's useful to know that you see the world in different colors than everybody else, just so you can be prepared. Obviously that's something I just am aware of today too, so that I don't say, this is definitely purple to people if I realize it might actually be blue, and others are seeing it as blue.
So. How do people respond to this particular trait of red-green colorblindness?
I would say that probably about half of people that I interact with already know somebody closely who is red-green colorblind, so it's no news to them, and they'll just say, oh yeah, my brother is also, or something of that nature. And then the other half, it's like a great party trick. And so the first time they hear that you're red-green colorblind, what they want to do is walk around the room going, what color is this? What color is this? What color is this? which is fun for about 30 seconds or so, and then you're kind of ready to move on. But that's been my general experience over the years.